So then Sugriv had asked him a question. Suppose today Ravan comes and surrenders that, okay, it's my mistake. I had abducted your wife. Please take your wife back. It is my mistake. Please forgive me. I'm sorry. Of course, Ravan would not do that because of his puffed up ego. But Sugriv said, suppose today Ravan comes and surrenders to you. Then what will you do? Because you have told Vivishan that, you know, you are now the next king of Lanka. So what will you do? Very tricky question, right? But then Lord Ram says, I have no problem. I will put Ravan in the throne of Ayodhya after I go back. So there is no way that he can compromise with his principles or his ideals. And he can also behave as he should behave, like he has behaved in case of Vibhishan. Even when most of the people in his camp suggested that do not take Vibhishan. He is Ravana's brother. He is not trustworthy. But he said, no, I trust him. And he, it's not that he is always like this, you know. For example, when he is about to, now I will talk of Mars here because Mars is also malefic. So for example, now when he had to cross this the ocean, you know, then every Lakshman suggested him that, what is this ocean for you? You can just take one arrow and dry this entire ocean in one shot. And Lord Ram said, no, no, but that's not good. That's not ethical. It's not the right way. So what I will do, I will sit and I will do puja for Samudra Dev, and you know, he will appear and he will tell me how to go. You know, imagine as Vishnu is doing that. Because he wants to set the example that even if you have power, follow the system. Just because you have power, don't trample on the head of others. Don't do that.
True.
It's not good for you nor for anybody else. So now he is doing it for 3 days and Samudra Dev, and he's least interested. And he doesn't have it. And then Lord Ram becomes very angry. He says, now you have tested my patience. Now he picks up the bow and his Mars is active now. He's like, and in fact, the Ramayana says, when he became angry, his eyes became very red, red like coal. Generally, when people get angry, their eyes become red. But have you seen anybody becoming red like coal? Red like coal. And you know, it's like by that reddishness in his eyes, the ocean starts boiling. You know, just by the reddishness in his eyes. And then this Samudra Dev comes out and he says, oh, please forgive me. I thought you were just another being like some, you know, normal human being. I will tell you the way, you know, we can put Nal Neel, we'll throw the stone and write Ram's name and the army can go like this. So now suppose his Mars would be debilitated. If Lord Ram's Mars would be debilitated, he would feel, oh, how can I do this? You know, I can't do it. It's not good. It's bad. But his Mars is also exalted. Yeah. So when it comes to fighting, then also nobody can defeat him. Or rather than saying nobody can defeat him, he will fight fully. Now, somebody may be defeated, that's secondary, but he will not give up the fight.
Yeah.
In the last moment, he will fight. And of course, there are many combinations. Yeah. For example, you know, Dharma, Karma, Dipati, Yoga also, you know, 9th Lord, 10th Lord, Mutual Aspect. Yeah. But we can go on talking about all this. But the point is that the Malefics, if well placed, like in case of Lord Ram, the Exalted Mars, he can use them very well when required. Now, in his case, that's the dynamics. His Jupiter and Mars both are exalted. So when he will hit you, he will hit you. But when he forgives, he will forgive also.
Yeah.
But then you may be thinking, what will he do at the end? Now, Moon is conjunct Jupiter, so he will only listen to what Jupiter says. He will not listen to Mars. So, if he has a chance to fight or forgive, he will prefer forgiving. Okay, so because Mars is exalted, so he can fight to his fullest and he can fight like nobody else. And because of Saturn, he's aware that if I go to the forest, there's so much suffering there. But he's aware that, yes, this is my responsibility, I should do it. He's not running away. He doesn't say that, oh, you want Bharat to be king? First, I will fight with Bharat and then I will see. Because, I mean, of course, if you fight with Bharat, then Bharat can't defeat him. But he doesn't say all this. He's aware, he's fully aware. Consciousness is very high that, okay, if I go to the forest,
where to use his powers and abilities.
So he knows when to use the malefics, and because the malefics are also exalted, so he also knows when to forgive and when to be interdicted. He doesn't pretend like, you know, macho man, you know, I can do anything, I can do whatever I want. In fact, when Lakshman is hit by this Shakti from Indraji, he tells that, my dear Lakshman, I have seen many terrible days in my life. You know, I was thrown out of my kingdom, banished. And the second thing was, my wife was kidnapped. These were two biggest sufferings which I got. But the suffering that I have today is nowhere in comparison to the earlier two sufferings. Today, my brother Lakshman, who has dedicated his life completely for me, he is lying there helplessly. And then he tells, you know, I wish I could have, you know, I don't know how should I, you know, bring you back to life. And then Hanumanji says that, yes, I will go and I will bring whatever is required. I will do the job necessary. And Hanumanji also has the same example. When the Vanaras are waiting and trying to figure out who will jump the to Lanka, they are sitting in Dhanushkodi and wondering who will, you know, jump. And then Hanumanji does not say, hey, you poor fellows, you know, I am sitting here, do you know who I am? You know, I am avatar of Shiva, I have been blessed by Yama, blah, blah, blah. He doesn't say like this. So Hanumanji also, like master, like servant. Hanumanji also, he does not keep beating the drum of independence, you know. Imagine Hanumanji had a LinkedIn profile, you know, or Facebook profile, you know. You'd write, eternally the servant of Lord Ram. That's what is mentioned in the Hanuman Chalisa. So, he's well aware, like Lord Ram, when to behave like malefics and when to behave like benefics. So, that's how you know how the dignities will behave.
True. So, here I have, at the end, I have one or two more questions. Mm-hmm. So, the one is that, if I asked you to explain each malefic planet in one sentence, as per the nature, how you will do it?
Okay, so for Saturn, I would say your ability to tolerate things. Rahu, I would say your ability to not cheat somebody. Because that's what I was discussing with you in the beginning. You know? So for example, many times people ask about the remedies for malefics. But the thing is, there are no remedies as such for malefics. There are remedies for benefics. The only remedy for malefics is that we have to use them when it is required, and when it's not, we have to stay away from them. So biggest remedy for Rahu, as I said, when we give a word to somebody, we promise something, that's the sun, you know, we should not retract. And for Ketu, don't be headless, read the scriptures, be enlightened, that's the line. And for Ketu at a spiritual level, as I said, you know, that other two gangs, in the other gang he's not a malefic, in the other gang he's a benefic, because he ultimately teaches you the ultimate reality of life, which is that you will lose everything one day. That's what Ketu does. Because Ketu doesn't have the head. Head is like, because according to science also, I mean, you can stay without your hands, legs, you know, your any part, but if you don't have the brain, you can't stay in the brain.
First house.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, the thing is, nothing in this world is actually ours. Everybody is like Ketu.
Yeah.
We are, that is why when I used to visit some many spiritual communities in 2010, so one, there was a community where I went. There, one guru was giving a lecture and his disciples were sitting in South India, and I also attended. And everybody were, you know, they were making note slides. But the peculiar thing was, in their notebook, generally, have you seen somebody's notebook? What is written, you know, name, so and so, title. But there, it was written in care of. Everybody was writing ICO, so-and-so, ICO, so-and-so. I was like confused, what is going on here? He's writing in care of. He's also writing, and the guy in the back also is writing in care of. And then I was thinking that, oh, maybe, you know, they have borrowed these notebooks from somebody or they forgot to bring. But then I was like, wherever I go, it's written ICO. What is this ICO? And then I called one of my seniors and asked him, hey, why, before your name, why are you writing ICO in care of? And he said that because this is not my notebook. I said, then whose notebook is this? Well, this is God's property. I'm just taking care of it. I was like, wow, that's a statement, in care of. So after that, whatever things I have, I also never write my name. I had in care of, then I write my name. Because that makes your life so much easier. Otherwise, you'll be thinking, oh, I lost that. Now, that doesn't mean you become irresponsible, but your constant craving for things go away because you know that, anyways, it's not mine, it's somebody else's.
Actually, it is teaching you the importance of benefits, the importance of interdependence. You know, you learn to give credit to others, I think.
Yes.
From and such things.
Talk of malefics and benefics in the Ramayana. Who is the one who has done the most malefic tasks? It's Hanumanji. Malefic, in a, not in a bad sense, the most tough thing Hanumanji has done.
Yeah.
But he doesn't keep boasting. Oh, you know, it was me, you know, who burned the Lanka of Ravan. You know, Ravan, you know, remember, you know, somebody has burned my entire city. I have taken the Drongiri Parvat, the mountain. I have done what not, you know. I have brought, when Lord Ram and Lakshman, they were unconscious by the Nagpas, I brought Garuda from Vaikuntha, and by help of Garuda, I mean, somebody can say, if Hanumanji would not have brought Garuda, then maybe Lord Ram and Lakshman would have never become conscious again from the Nagpas. But he doesn't behave like that. Whenever somebody asks him anything, he always says, it is not my power, it is by the grace of Ram it has happened. And all the great personalities throughout the Vedic literatures, they will always behave like this. Any character you see, you know, for example, if you take Arjuna's example, when he has to kill Jayadrath to avenge the death of Abhimanyu, he crosses 11 miles. That's not a short distance, you know, it's a very long distance. He crosses 11 miles to kill this Jayadrath. And finally, he does it with Krishna's help, of course. But he has also done so much. Krishna helps at the end, not in the beginning. And then when everybody praises him, oh, Arjuna, you are so great. You achieved this stupendous feat. You defeated all the Maharathis that day and you smashed. But he doesn't say that. Says, no, it was only because Krishna was there with me, I could do it. Now, somebody may take it literally. And he may think that, oh, anyways, Arjuna is never a good warrior. No. Only because Krishna was there, he was protected. Otherwise, no chance. No, that's stupid to say like this. He did it, but because he's so great, he doesn't feel that he has done it. And on the other side, we have Duryodhana, Saturn and Rahu conjunction in first house. Duryodhana and company, Ravan and company, this is the other DNC, RNC. Yes. Duryodhana would always feel, this is my throne. I should sit in this throne. Who are these Pandavas? It is my throne. So Duryodhana always had this sense of emptiness inside, which is again Saturn. And that is why he would hatch plots to, you know, kill the Pandavas, insult them, you know, with Yudhishthir or Draupadi or whoever they are, you know, always insulting, always, you know, denigrating them. In fact, Duryodhana would also say the level of this personality to so much low he can go that he also once said, oh, actually, who are these Pandavas? I don't believe that they are, you know, sons of Pandu. Because I heard that they were born with from Kunti Devi and some other devatas or something. So indirectly he was hinting at the character of Kunti Devi also, that Kunti Devi is not very pure. So maybe these five kids are not, you know, my uncle Pandu's son. So essentially they don't deserve to sit in the throne. So that's what Saturn and Rahu does. Always that cheating propensity and all to feed that emptiness inside. So for Rahu, I would say don't be empty. Be lighthearted. Always try to see good in others. That's the biggest remedy for Jupiter. In fact, I have one video which I will upload about Jupiter and Venus. But always try to see the good in others. And by that, you will, because if you do this, then all the problems are solved. Because then, like Hanumanji's case, he always would say, you know, he would say Jai Shri Ram. That's his tagline. So you would always feel that although he is very powerful, but he would feel that because I am chanting Ram's name, so I am able to achieve this. Now somebody may think, oh, maybe I will chant Ram's name and I will also jump 100 miles, but I can't do that. Because so that shows that it is not that literally because he was chanting the name of Ram that he was able to do. He was himself also very powerful, you see. He had all the malefics in full, you know, full independence was there, and he was very intelligent also to figure out, you know, when to do what, when not to do what. So Mars was strong, Sun was strong, everybody was very strong mischance. And when he goes to Lanka, you know, this Mainak Parvat comes in between. And Mainak Parvat said, hey, I want to offer you some rest. Have some, just chill out, just sit and, you know, then go. And then he says, sorry, I can't go. I can't sit because I don't have time. So he's very much fixed. He's very much focused, which comes from, you know, Sun. But for Ravana, it was opposite. Ego, I am the king of the demons, you know, I will sit in the throne. I will, Ravana's favorite job was abducting the, many times people, you know, when they have free time, what they do, you know, they'll watch TV or they'll do something like eat popcorn, see movies. So Ravana's favorite job was abducting the wives of other people. That was his favorite job. That was like his, play time, you know, it's like his fun time. And that is why he and Vali were best friends, because birds of the same feather always talk together. So he abducted Sita, he had violated the chastity of Rambha, he had violated Vedvati, and that's what his best friend Vali had done. He had abducted the wife of his own brother, you know, Sugriv. Can you just believe it? These people existed at that time, what to speak of Kali Yuga. So that sense of deficiency, that I need more, you know. I'm not happy with one wife or one woman. I need more and more. So that is a sense of deficiency which the malefics can sometimes give. So we need to watch out and realize that that's it. One is done. So that is all I would say. And just try to see the good in others. By that, all the malefics, you'll be able to use the malefics in the right way.
In the correct way, yeah.
The right spirit, because they are required, but we cannot make them God, you see.
Yeah.
Any last question you have?
No. This is it. And It was truly a wonderful session, Babaji. Thank you so much again for coming on our channel and guiding everyone about the role of malefic planets in Kali Yuga. And I hope that we will soon record another session with you.
Well, sure.
In future. Always.
And thank you very much for so long. And also to Zen Madam and your entire team. And it was a great experience. Very soon we will record again.
And of course.
All the best for your page and your group for to everybody. And may everybody use the benefics in the right spirit and also the malefics when required.
Yeah, that's true. So this is the take from the video, and
The takeaway is, don't be fearful of malefics. They are not bad planets. True. They are required.
Yeah.
Don't make them God. Use the benefics and be happy. And don't use benefics without malefics. You will be weak and miserable.
True.
Don't only use malefics, then you will be independent and lonely and miserable.
Yeah, exactly. So maintain a thin line between these
two. Use the malefics and then you use the benefics over there. All right. So that will be all from my side. Thank you.
Great. So thank you. Thank you so much, Babaji.